Hey guys, my fifth recommended book is The Cortisol Connection by Shawn Talbott. Cortisol is a stress hormone, and while levels should naturally fluctuate across the day, in some people they are chronically elevated, causing health problems. A lot of it goes back to hunter-gatherer times, where our bodies need to be on high alert if there's any predators or danger around. If you've heard of the fight or flight response, that's where you're getting a shot of cortisol and adrenaline in response to a stimulus. Say there's a dangerous animal around, it's going to release the cortisol that's going to get you fired up and ready to either fight it or run away from it. Modern day stressors are rarely life-threatening and often more prolonged, but our body responds to it in the same way as a physical threat. Unlike a dangerous animal, which is going to resolve itself in several minutes, if you're worried you're going to lose your job, then that's a constant stress that could plague you for days or even weeks. Worrying and anxiety produce the same response as if what we're thinking about is actually happening to us. Thinking about losing your job produces a similar physical response to if we actually lost the job, which is a stressful experience. The same is true if something has happened to you and you find yourself replaying it over and over in your head. To your body, it's like the event is really happening hundreds of times, and you might notice while you're thinking about it, you feel physically bad. My three bullet points relate to the physical symptoms that occur with chronic stress, and I recommend reading The Cortisol Connection to learn what lifestyle changes can reduce those. Number one, stress increases cortisol, which in turn reduces testosterone, lowers sex drive, increases fatigue, and increases body fat. I think we can all agree those are things that we don't want to encourage. Two, body fat contains an enzyme called HSD, which increases cortisol within the cell, and this encourages even more fat production. This is an enzyme that increases with age, which is part of the reason for the expanding waistline known as middle-age spread. HSD activity also triples when you pursue a stressful diet such as ultra low calorie, so you're almost turbocharging your fat storage. Finally, the caffeine in a cup of coffee will raise your cortisol by around 30%. Cortisol helps with alertness, which is why our levels naturally peak around 8 a.m, but taking caffeine can interfere with the body waking itself up. It's best to delay that first cup of coffee until mid-morning, which allows your levels of cortisol to rise naturally. I hope you found this interesting. Notes on this and other recommended books are over at 9to5strength.com/books. Cheers.